In my last video, we covered DXVK, which massively improves the performance of GTA 4. If you haven't seen that video, I'd highly recommend watching it before watching this video. Although, don't follow the installation instructions in that video. Instead, use this video to install DXVK. Now, after that video, a lot of people started to have issues getting DXVK to work with their game. Unfortunately, there's only so much testing I can do myself, but since then, I've learned about a lot of these issues and how to solve them. So for this video, I'm going to show you how to install DXVK again, as well as providing solutions for many of the common problems you may run into. But before we begin, you need to know that DXVK will only work if your GPU supports Vulkan. If you're not sure whether your GPU supports Vulkan or not, just do a quick Google search. Since version 2.0 of DXVK, your GPU needs to support Vulkan 1.3. If your GPU doesn't support Vulkan 1.3, but supports older versions of Vulkan, you should download version 1.10.3 of DXVK. Realistically, most GPUs made in the last 10 years should support some version of Vulkan. If you can't find answers on Google about whether your GPU supports Vulkan or not, just make sure your GPU driver is up to date and test each version of DXVK by following this video. If you receive errors when trying to launch the game with DXVK, your GPU very likely doesn't support Vulkan, and DXVK won't work. Keep in mind, DXVK will perform differently on different PC setups. With the PC I used to test in my last video, it gave great performance improvements. But this may not be the case for everybody, so just keep that in mind. So, installing DXVK, let's do this again. I've only installed DXVK on the complete edition of GTA 4, which is the latest version on Steam. However, it should work with every version of GTA 4. The version of DXVK used in this video is version 2.2, which is the current latest version at the time of recording. To install DXVK, you'll need 7-zip to open the archive it comes in. I'll leave a link to 7-zip below. You don't need any other mods to get DXVK working. So, if you just want to install DXVK and then play GTA 4, you can do that. However, the PC version does have more issues aside from performance, including inferior graphics when compared to the console version. I have a video covering these differences, which I'll link on the screen now. Before you do install DXVK, go into your graphics settings in GTA 4 and take note of how much video memory you have. I have 8GB with my GTX 1070. That's shown as 8000MB. Type your video memory value down somewhere, as you'll need it later. Lastly, installation methods might change in the future, so be sure to check the description or pinned comment to see if anything has changed since I uploaded this video. Anyway, let's get to installing DXVK. Step 1. Download DXVK from the link in the description. Remember, download the version that will work with your GPU. For GPUs that support Vulkan 1.3, you can use the latest version of DXVK. For GPUs that don't support the latest version of Vulkan, you should download DXVK version 1.10.3. Step 2. Open the .gz archive with 7-zip. Once opened, open the .tar archive inside. Step 3. Open the DXVK folder inside that archive, then open the x32 folder. Make sure you open the x32 folder even if your system is 64-bit. The game is 32-bit, so that's why we use the 32-bit files. Step 4. Once you've opened the x32 folder, copy d3d9.dll to your GTA 4 folder. This is the folder where gta4.exe is located. Okay, that's DXVK installed. However, there's more we need to do. With DXVK installed, the game thinks you only have a small amount of video memory. This is a problem, as it won't allow you to change video settings if it thinks you have too little memory. To fix this, you need to force the game to use a specific video memory value. Now, in my last video, I did this using commandline.txt, basically a text file with launch options that the game will read. Unfortunately, this solution didn't work for a lot of you. I'm not entirely sure why, but there is another solution. So this method changes depending on the service you have the game on. So I'll cover it for the Steam version first, and then I'll cover it for the Rockstar Games Launcher version. If you haven't got the game on either platform, add GTA 4 to Steam as a non-Steam game. Then follow along with the Steam instructions for how to fix the issue. So, the Steam version first. Step 1. Right-click on GTA 4 in your Steam library and click Properties. Step 2. In the Launch Options text box, add the following. Dash available vid mem followed by the video memory value you took down earlier. So for me, that was 8000 megabytes. Next, add dash no mem restrict and dash no restrictions. And that's it. GTA 4 should now show the video memory value you've put into your launch options, and you should now be able to modify your graphics freely. If you use the Rockstar Games Launcher version, I'll show you how to do it there as well. I don't own GTA 4 on the Rockstar Games Launcher, so I'm going to use San Andreas here as an example. Step 1. Click on Settings in the Rockstar Games Launcher, and then select GTA 4 under My Installed Games. Step 2. In the Launch Arguments text box, add the following. Dash available vid mem followed by the video memory value you took down earlier. So for me, that was 8000 megabytes. Next, add dash no mem restrict and dash no restrictions. And you're done. GTA 4 should now show the correct video memory value. Lastly, for some users, DXVK can cause your screen's resolution to not be available in the game's video options. So to fix that, you need to use DXVK's configuration file. This doesn't come with DXVK by default, so we'll have to download it. So step 1, download the DXVK config from the link in the description. Step 2, copy the config file to your GTA 4 folder. Step 3, open the config file with any text editor, such as Notepad, click on Edit, and then click Find. Step 4, type the word aspect, and then press Enter to search. This should bring you to the option to force an aspect ratio. Step 5, remove the hashtag at the beginning of the option. Then, in between the quotation marks, type in the aspect ratio of your resolution. So, I play at 1440p, which is a 16:9 aspect ratio. 720p and 1080p are also 16:9 aspect ratios. So, you type the same if you play at those resolutions. Don't forget to save the file after you typed in your aspect ratio. And that's it. The config file forces the game to use an aspect ratio of your choosing, which restores resolutions that you might have been missing. I also had a lot of people ask whether DXVK is usable with ENV. I don't use ENV myself, but others have gotten DXVK to work with ENV. I won't cover it in this video, but there are guides out there which will help you with using DXVK and ENV together. I'll leave a link to one in the description below. Anyway, that is finally all. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a like. If you like GTA modding videos, don't forget to subscribe as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.